Assalamualaikum. Hello. Morning. Good afternoon. Good evening. So, I suppose by the time you listen to this recording, we've probably discussed in class and we've explained that we shall be having short recording sessions, yeah, on our subject matter of business mathematics. So let me remind you again that these recordings are not a substitute to our classes. So you need to attend our scheduled classes and tutorial sessions. So I hope we are all ready to learn something. So let's begin with the first chapter. So the first chapter will be on sequence and series. So there will be several parts. So this will be the first part of the first chapter. So what shall we discuss? We shall discuss shortly on the sequence of natural numbers, general sequences and patterns, and series as sum of terms in a sequence. Okay, let's begin. Now, natural numbers. So we are all very familiar with numbers. So we know how to count. We know how to enumerate, we know how to, do operations, basic arithmetic operations on numbers, especially natural numbers. So what are natural numbers? Natural numbers are numbers such as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. So we are very familiar with these numbers. We count by using these numbers. So perhaps today we shall introduce to ourselves the set of natural numbers. So the set of natural numbers are usually denoted by this symbol N, and the symbol N, which is which consists of all the natural numbers. So beginning with 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on and so forth. A set is a collection of objects. So as a set, N consists of objects or elements which are natural numbers. So let's not complicate things. We've understood this. So natural numbers are number lah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So as a set, we denote it as this big N or this symbol. But as a particular natural number, usually, we denote them using the letter small n. Although this is not necessarily the case. So you can use x or y or a, b, c, p, q, r or any symbols you like. But sometimes, whenever we want to especially emphasize that this particular object is a natural number, we use n. Whereas when we use x, y, z, probably we shall mean that they could take other sorts of numbers, not necessarily natural numbers. Meaning they can be negative numbers, they can be fractions, 2 over 3, they can be irrational numbers like square root of 2. So whenever you have a mixture or a combination of different sorts of numbers, but then we want to point out or we want to emphasize that this particular number is a natural number, we denote it by n. Although it is not necessary, it's not necessarily the case, tak semestinya. So n can take the value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Natural numbers represent sequence and ordering. Okay? A sequence and ordering is such that one thing is followed by another. Meaning the sequence or the arrangement of the objects matter. For instance, you may have several, say, apples. You have several apples and it does not matter the arrangement of the apples. You can put the biggest apple on the right hand side and the smallest apple on the left hand side, or it does not matter. You don't have to sort the apples according to the size or the weight. They are just 5 apples, for instance. But sometimes when we use natural numbers, we want to use it in such way that it denotes sequence and ordering, meaning there is a first place, there is a second place, there's third place, fourth place, and so on. For example, in one semester we have 14 weeks. So this most probably, by the time you listen to this, will be the first week. Next week will be the second week, and the week after will be the third week, all the way until the 14th week. Another example, we may want to refer to events according to particular time. For example, the first second, the second second, the third second, and so on. Or the first hour, the second hour, the third hour. So we may use natural numbers to refer to this sort of sequencing and ordering. Okay, now, these are examples of sequences. So naturally, natural numbers are also the set of natural number is also a form of a sequence, but the sequence is the most basic and most common sequence, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. But we may have sequences of numbers that may not be exactly natural numbers, but they consist of other sort of numbers, or in a different kind of sequence. So these are examples of sequences A, B, C, and D, and E. So let's look at the first sequence: 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. Okay? Do you notice any patterns in this sequence of numbers? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Is there any pattern in this sequence of numbers? Could we describe the pattern? Yes. We notice that each term, so there are 5 terms given here. The first term is 10. The second term is 20. The third term is 30. And the fourth term is 40. And the fifth term is 50. So we notice almost immediately that each term is 10 more than the previous term. So the first term is 10. You add another 10, you get 20. The second term is 20. You add another 10, you get 30. Okay? Add 10. Similarly, from 30, you add another 10, you get 40. From 40, you add another 10, you get 50. And then should we continue this sequence, our best guess would be, we just add another 10, which will obtain 60. And then we'll add another 10, we'll obtain 70, and so on and so forth. Okay, now what about the second sequence, B? So we have 105, 60, 15, 30. 105, 60, 15, and then you have 30. Do we notice any pattern? Yes? No? So if we take the difference, how do we get 60 from 105? How do you get 60 from 105? Yes, you have to subtract by 35. Right? So 105 minus, no, not 35, 45. Right? 105 minus 45 equals to 60. And then from 60, we check. If we subtract 60 by 45, do we get 15? Yes, we get 15. So 60 minus 45 is 15. Now from 15, if we subtract 45, do we get 30? Do we get minus 30? Yes. So 15 minus 45, we get minus 30. So again, we notice that there is a pattern in this sequence. And the pattern is, for each subsequent term, it is 45 less than the previous term. From each of the subsequent term is 45 less than the previous term. So if we are to continue this sequence, so from minus 30 subtract by 45, what do we get? Yes, we get minus 75. And then once you get minus 75, you subtract by another 45, what do you get? Yes, you get minus 120. Am I correct? This is 25. Yes, at 120. Okay, you can proceed by checking the third sequence, C, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22. Do we notice any pattern? I hope this is obvious to all of us that these are merely sequence of even numbers, nombor genap. So 14, 16, 18, 20, 22. So the next even number would be 24. The next even number would be 26, and so on and so forth. What about D? So here you have 3, 9, 27, 81, and so on. Do you notice any pattern? Now here, if we look for the difference between the terms, kan, kita lihat dia punya perbezaan antara sebutan-sebutan ini, we notice that the difference are different. Okay? From 3 to 9, the difference is 6. 3 plus 6 equals to 9. But from 9 to 27, the difference is 18. From 27 to 81, the difference is something else. So the difference is different. We do not have a consistent change in terms of the difference between two consecutive terms, antara dua sebutan yang berturutan. However, does this mean that there exists no pattern in this particular sequence? Not necessarily. Yes, not necessarily. Why? Because there may be other forms of patterns that does not involve the difference between two consecutive terms. Perhaps it involves other arithmetic operations. And in fact, there is a pattern to this. So this is 3, and 9 is actually 3 times 3. 3 multiplied by 3 is equal to 9. And then 9 multiplied by 3 is equal to 27. So 3 multiplied by 3 equals to 9. 9 multiplied by 3 equals to 27. 27 multiplied by 3 equals to 81. And 81 multiplied, if we want to continue this sequence, and so we our best guess, kita punya tekaan lah kan, berdasarkan pattern yang kita dah temukan kan, based on the patterns that we've observed in the previous terms, our best guess is to continue the same pattern. Okay, continuing the same pattern means we multiply 81 by 3. So 8 times 3 is 24, 1 times 3 is 3. Yeah? So 81 multiplied by 3, the next term in the sequence will be 243. Okay? And so on and so forth. We can continue the sequence as far as we wish. And finally, let's look at example E. Look at this sequence 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, and 13. 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. Can you describe this sequence? Now, if you try to look at the difference between two consecutive terms, you may find that the difference are not the same. It appears there is no regularity in the difference. Between 2 and 3, the difference is 1. Between 3 and 5, the difference is 2. Between 5 and 7, the difference is 2. Between 7 and 11, the difference is 4. Between 11 and 13, the difference is 2. So we are not able to discern any consistent difference between two consecutive terms. What about multiplication? 2 times what equals to 3? 2 times, say 1.5, ataupun 3 over 2. So 2 times 1.5 equals to 3. Now what about 3 times 1.5? 3 times 1.5 does not equal to 5. So again, we do not see any consistent pattern when it comes to multiplication. So is there any pattern to this? If you can find any pattern to this kind of sequence, you will be awarded with the Fields Medal in mathematics. Because this sequence is the sequence of prime numbers. These are a list of, these are prime numbers. 2 is the first prime number. 3 is the second prime number. 5 is the third prime number. And so on and so forth. And the nature or the pattern of prime numbers amongst the natural numbers has been the subject of very rigorous investigation in the subject of mathematics, particularly in number theory. Although a lot of things have been discovered, but the definite pattern that constitutes the arrangement of prime numbers in the number sequence is still unknown until today. So you might want to think about that, right? Now, having said that, a sequence of numbers may not necessarily have patterns. It is not a requirement for a sequence to have patterns. However, as human beings, we would like to know if there is a pattern in any sequence. Given a particular sequence, we would be interested or delighted to know if there is a consistent pattern in the sequence of whatever numbers they are. So that would be our line of investigation, our line of thinking. Okay, let's proceed with more examples. So once all this while, I just presented you with a sequence of just any numbers. But now we want to analyze, or we want to develop a systematic way of analyzing sequences. Okay, so how do we do this? Okay, first, we notice that any sequence will have the first, the second, the third, and the fourth term, and so on and so forth. Meaning, all sequence will have direct relation with natural numbers. For example, suppose you have a bunch of rambutan. So you now sekarang musim rambutan, and during this time of recording, some rambutan trees have you can see fruits, rambutan fruits. So you can pluck these rambutans, and then you may just arrange the rambutan lah in one line. So, and then you label the first rambutan as 1, the second rambutan as 2, the third rambutan as 3, and so on and so forth. And then you start peeling the rambutan and eating the rambutan. And then you start counting the seeds of the rambutan. So the first rambutan, you eat the rambutan, you notice that the number of seed is 1. Now you eat the second rambutan, again, the number of seed is 1. The third rambutan and the fourth and the fifth, they all have 1 seed. As we all know, rambutan has only 1 seed each in every fruit. So the sequence is just 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, right? So that's the sequence of the seeds of rambutan. Rarely, or I've never seen a rambutan without seeds or with more than 1 seed. Okay. Now, what about suppose that we have pokok manggis, and then we pluck all the manggis and we start eating the manggis, and we start counting the number of seeds. So the first manggis that we ate, we notice that there are 2 seeds. The second manggis, there are 2 seeds. The third manggis, there is 1 seed. The fourth manggis, a big one. We notice that there are 3 seeds. The fifth manggis, a big one, but we only have 1 seed, and so on and so forth. So this is an example of a sequence that may not have any patterns. So a manggis can have 1, 2, or 3 seeds, or maybe 1 or 2 seeds, most commonly. So there's no we could not discern any pattern in the number of seeds of buah manggis. Now we may ask, but this is sort of expected, because the number of rambutan and the number of manggis, the arrangement of rambutan and manggis, does not necessarily follow any sequence. You notice that we may rearrange them in however we wish. So this is probably not the best way to analyze a sequence. Perhaps this is not does not fit to be a proper sequence, because we mentioned earlier a sequence must have order, meaning they must have a meaningful order. Okay, now look at the third example. So the natural number is represented by H, or the H is represented by natural number in months, and the sequence that we need that we want to investigate is the height of a newborn baby. So a baby is being born. As the baby was born, the doctor or the nurse will measure the height or the length of the baby from head to toe, and notice and the result of the measurement is 50 centimeters. So the 0th week, as the baby was born, the length or the height is 50 centimeters. 1 week later, the nurse or the pediatrician or the doctor measured the height or the length of the baby again, and noticed that the baby has grown to 55 centimeters. And then next month, right? And then the month after, the measurement turned up to be 58 centimeters, and then 61 centimeters, 64 centimeters, and the fifth month, the baby's height or length is 65 centimeters. Now, in this sequence, we may or may not discover any strict or particular consistent pattern. However, this is a sequence because the natural number that is represented, that represents age, has a meaningful order. Meaning, you can't take the fourth week and put it at in the first week. It will not be meaningful to rearrange it like that. Whereas for the case for rambutan and manggis, it does not matter. You can take the fifth rambutan and put it at the first rambutan. You can take the fourth manggis and put it at the sixth manggis. It does not matter. I mean, the arrangement or the order does not matter. Whereas in sequence, the arrangement and order does not just does matter. The arrangement and the order is what defines the sequence. It is what makes the sequence a sequence. So this is not a sequence. The first two is not a proper sequence. Not a proper sequence. This is also not a proper sequence. Now, the third one, this is a proper sequence. Proper sequence. This is a sequence. So the first two is not a are not sequences. The third one is a sequence, although we may not discern any patterns, any strictly consistent patterns in the sequence. Now, the next examples, the next three examples are all proper sequences. And then you may observe that we use time to represent the natural numbers. So time in years 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Value of a car. Suppose you buy a car during the day of your purchase. The value of the car is 55,000 ringgit. But then after 1 year, the value will decrease by, say, 5,000 ringgit. So the value of the car will be 50,000 ringgit. Another year pass, the value of the car will decrease by another 5,000. So the value of the car becomes 45,000 ringgit, and so on and so forth. Similarly, time in years, the value of investment. Suppose you invest 2,000 ringgit in a particular investment scheme or an investment account. And then after 1 year, you earn some dividend. So the amount of money in that account has increased from 2,000 to 2,100 ringgit. Another year pass, you get another dividend. The money in the account has increased to 2,205 ringgit, and so on and so forth. Or the price of commodities such as gold. So this is actually real price. I took it from Bank Negara. This is a quarter ounce, I believe, of gold. This is days. You see that this is also a proper sequence. Although in the first two case, there is clear pattern that can be discerned from the sequence. Whereas the third example, there's no clear pattern that could be discerned. Sometimes the price goes up, sometimes the price goes down. Now, in general, we may represent sequences in this sort of table. So the table may have two columns or two rows. In our case, we have two rows. The first row represent the sequence of natural numbers. So we represent denoted by n. And then n can take the value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. The second row or the second column is the actual term. So represented by T subscript N, so TN, where N takes the value of natural number. So we have the first term is T1, the second term is T2, the third term is T3, the fourth term is T4, and so on and so forth. So this is how we propose how we would analyze sequences, so any sequences. So now let's check our understanding. Okay, so suppose we have an example of a sequence. The first example being the sequence of even numbers, denoted by En, and then we define En as 2 times n. Okay, can we write the first 5 terms of the sequence En? Okay, can we do this? Yes, we can. Yeah? So, first, let's just fill in the first row, which is the sequence of natural numbers. So, we begin with the first term. So, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The question asks for the first 5 terms. Yeah. Well, if you are hardworking or if you have more time, you want to do the 6th term, by all means. Yeah. Now, what is the first term? So, what is E1? So, we have in the example, we've defined En equals to 2n. So, E1 equals to 2 times 1, which is 2. So, the first term is 2. What about the second term? The second term is E2. E2 is equals to 2 times 2, 2n. So 2 times n, n equals to 2. So 2 times 2, this is equals to 4. So this is 4. What about E3? E3 equals to 2 times n. So n equals to 3. So 2 times 3. 2 times 3 equals to 6. And you may proceed. So you end up with the sequence of even numbers. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, and so on and so forth. What about the second example? The sequence of odd numbers. Okay, so let's first let's fill in the sequence of natural numbers. The first term, second term, third term, fourth term, fifth term, or sixth term. Now, what is O1? So, On, if you remember, was defined as 2n minus 1. So, O1 is equal to 2 times 1 minus 1. So, 2 times 1 equals to 2 minus 1. So, 2 minus 1 equals to 1. So, here you get 1. What about O2? The second term. O2 is equals to 2 times n minus 1. N equals to 2. So, 2 times 2 minus 1. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. So, the second term is 3. What about the third term? The third term is O3. This is equal to 2 times n, which is equal to 3. So, 2 times 3 minus 1. So, 2 times 3 equals to 6. 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. So, the third term is 5. So, you can proceed and you'll notice that we will be generating the sequence of odd numbers. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, and so on. I hope by now we are very clear with the idea of a sequence. Now, in relation to sequences, we shall need to introduce another concept, which is series. So, what is a series? In mathematics, a series is a sum of the terms in a sequence. For example, consider the sequence of natural numbers, Tn equals to n. So, you may denote the sequence of natural numbers just like this, it's just n, kan? 1 2 3 4 5 lah, kan? Okay, the sequence of natural numbers, so the first term is 1, the second term is 2, the third term is 3, the 10th term is 10, the 100th term is 100, the 1 millionth term is 1 million, the nth term is n. Now, all these are denoted by T subscript n, yes? So T subscript n usually denote the term. However, we may denote another concept, which is series, which is the sum of the sequence, by another letter, because it is a sum. So let's use S. So S subscript n is the sum of the first n terms of the sequence Tn. So in other words, mathematically, we write Sn or S subscript n as equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus T4 all the way to plus Tn. Okay, so now let's represent this in of the form of a table. So let's look at this table on the right. So now in this table, instead of we are arranging the numbers in rows, we now arrange the numbers in columns. So you are free to use rows or columns depending on whichever that is suitable, whichever that is useful or purposeful for your particular context. Sometimes you have a slide like what I have now. So if it is more convenient to use columns instead of rows, because I've got the space is more spacious horizontally, then we use columns. Or you want to see the patterns, the patterns not just up to the fourth term, you may want up to the 40th term. If you want to represent the 40th from the first to the 40th term in a slide like this, probably you run out of space, you quickly run out of space. So you might want to use rows, because you can have a more lengthy space horizontally instead of vertically. Anyway, so let's look at this table. So the first column is the column of natural numbers, which is n. So n is the first term is 1, 2, the second term is 2, third term is 3, 4, and so on and so forth. And then we know that the sequence itself is n. It's just sequence of natural numbers. So Tn equals to n. So the values are the same. So 1, 2, 3, 4 juga. Now, what about the third column here, Sn? Do we notice, can you discern how we get these numbers? So notice that Sn is just the sum of the first n terms. So the first term, the first one term is just the first term lah, which is 1. So S1 equals to 1. Now S2, so S1 equals to 1. S1. Now S2 equals to T1 plus T2. So T1 is 1, T2 is 2, so equals to 1 plus 2. So 1 plus 2 equals to 3. S3 is equal to 1 plus 2 plus the third term is 3. So first term plus second term plus third term. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equal to 6. S4 is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So 6 plus 4, this is equal to 10. So is it clear to you the meaning of series, or the meaning of Sn, which is the sum of the first n terms? I hope that it is clear to you the meaning of SN. So let's check our understanding. So now let's fill in this the column of this table with where the sequence is no longer the sequence of natural numbers but the sequence of odd numbers. Okay, so let's do this. So the natural numbers are given 1, 2, 3, 4. Now the sequence of odd numbers is also given 1, 3, 5, 7. Now what about the sequence of, not the sequence, the series, eh? The sequence of the sum of the first n terms. Okay, the sum of the first one term is just 1. And my, okay, 1. The sum of the first two terms is 1 plus 3, so equals to 4. The sum of the first three terms is 1 plus 3 plus 5, and this is equals to 9. What about the sum of the first four terms? So this is 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7. So 9 plus 7, this is equal to 16. So S1 equals to 1, S2 equals to 4, S3 equals to 9, S4 equals to 16. Do you notice anything peculiar about these numbers? 1, 4, 9, 16. Do you notice that? I leave that as an exercise. Maybe we shall discuss this in class. Yeah? Now, further exercises for you to do. Okay, let's to check our understanding. There are five sequences given here, TNs. So for each of these sequences, list the five terms of the sequence and also the first five sums, first sums of the first n terms. So you may want to do this on your own, but let's just do two of them, one or two of them here. So let's do the first one. So again, n is just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now tn is equals to 3n. So 3 times 1 is 3. 3 times 2 is 6. 3 times 3 is 9. 3 times 4 is 12. 3 times 5 is 15. Now, what about Sn? So, S1 is equal to 3. S2 is equal to 3 plus 6, 9. Okay. S3 is equal to 3 plus 6 plus 9 equals to 18. S4 is equal to 3 plus 6 plus 9 plus 12 equals to 18 plus 12 equals to what? 30. And S5, 3 plus 9 plus 6 plus 9 plus 12 plus 15 equals to 45. Okay, let's do the second example. Again, n equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Tn is equal to n square. Okay, n square. N square means n times n. N multiplied by itself. So 1 square is equal to 1. Or 1 times 1 equals to 1. 2 square is equals to 4. 2 times 2 equals to 4. 3 square is equals to 9. 3 times 3 equals to 9. 4 square is equal to 16. 4 times 4 is equals to 16. And 5 squared is equals to 25. 5 times 5 is 25. What about the sum of the first n terms? The first one term is equal to just 1. The sum of the first two terms is equals to 1 plus 4 equals to 5. The first three terms is equal to 14. The first four terms is equals to 30. The first five term is equals to, the sum of the first five terms is equals to 55. As for the other three examples, I leave that as an exercise. We may discuss in class, maybe next week or shortly in the future. So this is the end of part one. So any questions and discussions, you may ask through our WhatsApp group or in our Google Classroom, or you may express your questions and discussions in class. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.